All right, I'm being told Abhishek Manusumbi of the Congress is holding a press conference. Let's cut across.
Look at the facts. You have the government of India for over a year before that, or 1.5 years before that, seeking very, very serious information, presence, proceedings, prosecution against this person. And we are also not concerned with Mr. Modi, we are concerned with the government. You have the government of India seeking information, prosecution, presence, possible extradition. You have a fugitive. You have the foreign minister making a private side conversation. And the foreign minister's close relatives, one is a lawyer for that fugitive and the other one is offered a job on the fugitive's company. The offer was subsequently withdrawn is irrelevant. What does it establish? Does it justify this prime minister who says na khaunga na khane dunga, his silence? Does it require some accountability rather than different BJP ministers saying there is no stigma, there is no guilt? It is like a family member of mine giving me a clean chit. It is like a parent saying that my child is innocent. Who is giving this certificate of innocence? The BJP minister, the BJP president. It is a very serious matter. Just consider further. A judgment is given by the Delhi High Court. The person who argued before the single judge and the division bench for the government, a then additional Solicitor General, even his opinion is not taken whether to appeal it. Forget others, even the person who has argued, his opinion is not taken. Therefore, there is a complete direct factual web of deceit, of prevarication, of avoidance. And at the highest echelons of government, you are having one, on the one hand, deafening silence, on the other hand, casual clean chits. They are trying to brazen it out. We demand through you that this can't be silenced in the manner which the government is attempting. And let me tell you that it is a situation where the more you try to hide, the more the truth unravels itself. Take the case of Rajasthan. Let me give you a new angle to it. Let us for a minute forget whether you own the palace or I own the palace. Just for a minute, I am assuming there is a lot of credible evidence to suggest that government property was converted to private use. But I am now making it simple for you. Assume A or B owned it. The issue is what? The issue is not a title ownership. The issue is that Mr. Lalit Modi invested admittedly with the son of the sitting chief minister, then leader of opposition. He invested admittedly in shares. He invested admittedly in money for the hotel. Whether he invested in the belief that it is owned by you or he invested in the belief that it is owned by the government is a secondary question. Does it not directly establish a nexus? Just consider, share value is admitted, investment in hotel is admitted, friendship is admitted, close friendship is admitted. A representation to all and sundry is admitted that Mr. Modi is a very deserving character. All admitted, huh? A request to suppress the information and not to reveal that Mrs. Rajay has signed it is admitted. Now I ask myself that as a citizen of India, do you require some answers or not? And till such answers are given, not by a BJP minister or the BJP president, that all BJP persons are clean chits, till an answer is given by a Supreme Court SIT, till an answer is given by the CBI, till the answer is given by the ED, till the answer is given by any independent agency, Commission of Inquiry under the Commission of Inquiry Act, which morality permits these people to function? Did Mr. Ashwani Kumar had any documentary material against him. Was Mr. Natwar Singh convicted in a court of law? Which morality are we talking about? Are we talking of a new rule of Modi morality, the MM rule? A new morality by which Mr. Taude is judged, Ms. Irani is judged, Ms. Munde is judged, but not by the same rule is Mr. Tomar judged. The judgment rule for Mr. Tomar is different, and we are not supporting Mr. Tomar at all. I am giving you an idea of the discriminatory, biased, multiple hypocritical approaches of the BJP. The judgment standard for Mr. Tomar is X. The judgment standard for Ms. Irani and Mr. Taude is Y. Therefore, I think to suggest and to think that the people of this country are, pardon my use of the word, fools or eat grass or will swallow whatever you will say, is highly presumptuous, insulting in the extreme, and does not behove of any democratic government. And frankly, we don't care about BJP ministers and BJP president. We want the Prime Minister to speak. He is our Prime Minister. He is the country's Prime Minister. He has a constitutional position. He owes it to the nation to break this deafening silence. मैं समझता हूँ कि ये एक ऐसे मुकाम पे मुद्दा पहुँच गया है कि कभी भी किसी देश में, भारतवर्ष में, इतने वर्षों में ये दिखने को नहीं मिला कि माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जो इतना अच्छा बोलते हैं वो इस प्रकार का मौन व्रत, इस प्रकार की चुप्पी, इस प्रकार का योगा आसन जो नया बनाया गया है मौन आसन, उसको करते रहें हमेशा, सदैव, निरंतर. हमने आपके समक्ष कई जनहित के, जवाबदेही के प्रश्न रखे हैं. मैं संक्षेप में आपको दोहरा दूं कि उन प्रश्नों की श्रृंखला में जो एक नया बहुत महत्वपूर्ण मुद्दा उठा है कि एक तरफ तो माननीय विदेश मंत्री मानते हैं कि उन्होंने, जिसको कहते हैं ह्यूमैनिटेरियन ग्राउंड्स कहा गया है, एक याचिका दी, एक निवेदन किया, वो एक भगोड़े के लिए, एक अभियुक्त के लिए, एक व्यक्ति जिसके विरुद्ध सरकार कई कार्रवाइयां कर रही है उसके विषय में किया गया. ये भी माना गया है कि उनकी पुत्री उनकी वकील थी, और मैं उनकी पुत्री के विरुद्ध कुछ नहीं कहना चाहता, उनका पूरा हक है एक वकील होने का. साथ साथ अब ये विदित हुआ है कि उनके निकट संबंधी को माननीय मोदी जी ने अपनी कंपनी में डायरेक्टर की हैसियत, अपनी खुद की जगह इन प्लेस ऑफ मिस्टर मोदी ऑफर की गई, लिखित रूप से कहा गया, की गई. ये महत्वपूर्ण या रेलेवेंट एकदम नहीं है कि वो बाद में विड्रॉ हो गई 20-25 दिन बाद. इस सब संदर्भ में जो मूल प्रश्न हमने पूछा था कि कभी ये हो सकता है कि सरकार का एक डिपार्टमेंट, पूरा मंत्रालय आपके पीछे लगा है, कार्रवाई हो रही है, विदेश में हो रही है, कोर्ट में हो रही है, और ए, आप अपने खुद के मंत्रालय में, जो कि दूसरा मंत्रालय है सरकार का, खुद के मंत्रालय में बिना चर्चा किए, बिना पूछे ऐसा पैरवी करेंगे उस व्यक्ति के विषय में. कभी ऐसा हो सकता है कि आप बिना उस एडिशनल सॉलिसिटर जनरल से वार्तालाप किए, बात किए, उनकी ओपिनियन लिए अपील नहीं करेंगे.